It's Lego Jang here with a look at Pyrox from Lego Hero Factory's Brain Attack Wave 1 release. This is just a 50-piece set. Looks like a relatively large bag for the number of parts that are in there. But speaking of the parts, let's go ahead and open up that bag and see what parts are in there. Well, that's kind of a bag of goodness right there. Okay. See a handful of things that I'm very interested in. First off, well, regular torso piece, the wide style with the two ball joints in close. That's what he's going to be based on. You can pause the video if you want to just count out which parts are used down here in the ball and socket joints, all standard stuff there. He's got one hand, one black hand, and you've got armor pieces. Got five of these number three pieces in black, and then this is a very nice print. Very nice print. I think it works together well. The use of that particular red color is particularly good to me because it looks very similar to the reddish orange color of the piece, so it integrates well and has really nice texture on it. So I actually like this one. This is probably my favorite printed piece to date in all of Hero Factory. Main body piece we've got in a dark red. So that's a new color for this piece. That's kind of exciting. He's got one big black club hand thing. This add-on chest piece is in a gunmetal gray, so that's a little different. It's one of the only gunmetal pieces in this set. It's gonna stand out a little bit. We've got a couple of these rock-like pieces that were also used on Bruiser, but here they're in the dark red. And it's nice to have a pair of a new color of a piece, in this case a new piece also for this series, rather than them giving you just one. They often do that where they'll give you a brand new type of armor piece or brand new, you know, some really interesting piece that's useful for mock making, but they'll give you just one in a set. So I always appreciate having two. For feet, they use feet from the Ben 10 series, although these may have been updated. Maybe not. No, these may have been designed during the transition period when Hero Factory was still undergoing design. These claw pieces, large rounded claw pieces, we have four of these in the transparent neon reddish orange. That's cool. Very bright, and those stand out pretty well. We've got two of these flame pieces, which are also included in Inferno XL. I really like the design on these and the combination of the two colors, how they kind of bleed them in or blend them into each other. Really well done right there. Got again from Ben 10 sets, two of these long horn pieces in black here. His head's the same standard head with the neon bright green color. Really stands out from everything else. I'm not sure how that'll work out. Here's his face. He's got a huge face, just enormous, way bigger than any of the others. Big old face with a kind of minotaur style ring going through his nose. Got some texture on it, really mean spike chin there and everything. It's pretty bad. And then of course the requisite attacking brain parasite controller thingy. This one is in a translucent yellow. It's a different yellow. So this is not quite the neon greenish yellow, and it's not quite a plain yellow. It's kind of in between. Still glows a little bit, but looks pretty cool. Works together, I think, with the red. In this set, we've got one of these new pieces. Very useful for attaching three axle-sized items side by side. This is new for this series of release. It's been used in one other set. And then amongst these little p- pieces, random little pieces that are over here. You can just see what they are, but amongst them, you have this piece that I have not seen before in a medium gray. That is an interesting piece. I want lots of these. I have a feeling that these can be very, very useful. Yeah, it's just a right angle with a pin in between. Should be super, super useful for mock making. Okay, enough staring at the parts. Let's go ahead and start putting these parts together. Pyrox has arrived. There we are, all built together. This guy's got a lot of personality coming through. A lot of presence in his eyes. Let's take a look at this guy from some different angles. See how it all came together. Definitely has that Minotaur theme going to him, but only to a point. It's kind of funny with the huge face and then the short little stubby legs. And I don't have this one posed perfectly, so it's not completely stable. Also the legs or the feet are a little bit on the short side, so I think I probably need to pose this a little differently just to change the center of gravity. You can see that kind of wants to tip forward right now. But I'll see about fixing that in just a second right here after I get through showing them from different angles and such. Yeah, pretty cool looking, right? All right, let me move this forward and that will just give him better balance, like so, something like that. Get this to settle in where it wants to be, roughly. Forward, back maybe. Yeah, okay. And you get the idea. This thing is pretty cool to me. The whole thing. I think it came together pretty well. This is the first time in a while that I've seen just a consistent color scheme for the bones. Hair Factory sets keep mixing different colors of bones together. And every once in a while, it's nice to just have one that's just consistent all the way through, that just goes in with his overall, or the character's overall color scheme. Really bright, I guess lava infused fingers. Those are just glowing with heat. Maybe they're kind of metallic, or maybe he's got kind of lava in his blood. You know, it's just so much heat inside of him, and his fingers glow. And got this one piece over here. It's the one single piece looks a little bit out of place, but I still like the piece. I think actually from here it's not that bad. Kind of, I think maybe if this was black instead, it would give more of a gradient of color coming from the black into this and then coming out to the brighter. But that's okay. I also wish that this piece here was in black instead of gunmetal gray. I don't see a reason for that to be the gunmetal color. But it's not bad. I can see the purpose for it. This is great. It spins. You know, so it's just, you can just make a kind of a swirling fire just output like a torch. And it's just like, you know, adds a little menacing nature to it. I don't know why they use the green head. You can barely even see it in there, thankfully. I'm really happy that you can barely see it, because it doesn't fit with the rest of the thing. I mean, why not just make that in this color right here? They have the color. It's not like there's a shortage of that color of dye for the plastic, just use it. You know, I mean, like the eyes from the thing that's possessing him, those are red. It's obviously he's got heat flowing through his veins. All you get out of the green is just right here, and that could easily have been either this color or this color. You know, use the yellow color. But this works out brilliantly. It shows you just another way that you can use the multiple attachment points on these new head pieces, the core head pieces. You know, you've got something attached from the top, from the front, and from the side. That's really good. I like these pieces. Those worked out well here. Just hooking them directly onto the armor like they're supposed to be. Nothing, no trick, nothing special there. They came out pretty well. In all, I think this is a successful villain character. I think it's a pretty good set. He's got a lot of personality to him. He's got a lot of character. He's got some playability. He's definitely menacing. And just visually, aesthetically, he's interesting. He stands out. He doesn't look just like other characters. Pretty happy with this one. That is Pyrox from the Brain Attack Wave 1 releases from LEGO Hero Factory. Thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed that. I definitely enjoyed that. And stay tuned for more. YouTube.com/LEGOJANG. Please be sure to subscribe if you have not already. And I'll be talking to you again soon.